In this video, I'm gonna be showing you how to turn a photo into an anime. So let's get started. So first off, I'm gonna go to camera raw filter and I'm gonna start making some changes. Starting with the temperature, I'm gonna move this to plus 14. Then the tint to minus 7. And you know what, this is gonna take a while, so I'm gonna show you the final values. Okay, then we're not exactly done, but this is kind of a base plate on which we're gonna add a few more effects. And also, I made this into a preset and you can download it by clicking the link in the description. And this preset can be used on various types of images such as this one. So I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna select the anime base plate and click OK. And there we go. But mind you, this preset have to be adjusted depending on the image that you're using. Now let's say you wanted to apply this preset to this image. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Now this looks alright, but you can always adjust these values to make it look better. Alright then, so coming all the way back to our initial image. So next up, what we're gonna do here is make some enhancements so that it looks more like an anime and less like a photo. And again, I used this image specifically to show you these enhancements. For certain images, the preset would just be enough, but it never hurts to go the extra mile, right? Alright, so I'm gonna start off by adding a layer on top, then turn the blend mode to soft light. And then by picking the shade of yellow and using this gradient tool, I'm gonna paint in some light coming from the left. And after that, I'm gonna add the next layer on top. And this time turn the blend mode to overlay. And by using black as the foreground color, I'm gonna add some darkness at the bottom and on the right side, like so. Then reduce the opacity to about 50%. And then using a layer mask, erase some of it from around this region. And then I'm gonna add another layer on top and I'm gonna select this color. And then I'm gonna change the blend mode to color dodge and add some light coming from the left side just like before. Then reduce its opacity to about 19%. Then clean up the bottom region by using a layer mask. And I'm gonna group that together. That looks good. Before and after. Before and after. So the first part is complete. And now I'm gonna start painting over some of these objects one by one, starting off with this building in the foreground. And for that, I'm gonna be using soft light as the blending mode. So I'm gonna make a rough selection of this section of the building. And then I'm gonna fill this selection with this color, which is very similar to the color of the building, but a bit brighter. And then I'm gonna do the same thing for this whole area. And done. Now this process gives it a nice painted look. Alright, so I'm gonna do the same thing for some of these other objects in the image as well. And while you're doing this, make sure to use soft light as the blending mode and a shade of color that matches the initial color. And you can also reduce the opacity of the layer if necessary, like I've done here. And now I'm gonna go to the original image and make a selection of this thing over here and then copy it onto a new layer and then repeat the same thing for the girl as well. And then I'm gonna add another layer behind the girl and this thing and then turn it to soft light, and by using this shade of yellow, I'm gonna paint over the pavement and add some light over here as well. And then I'm gonna add a layer on top of this and then clip it and change its blending mode to soft light. And by using this shade of orange, I'm gonna paint some highlights on the girl and this pipe thing as well. And I'm gonna also make her clothes a bit more brighter, similar to what I've done with the buildings. And now I'm gonna add more highlights and rim light by using a shade of orange, but this time by using color dodge as the blending mode. And then I'm gonna erase some effects from over here. And yeah, that looks nice. Alright, so we're done with this part as well. Now the next thing you want to do is add some lens flares, which kind of sounds a bit odd, but generally you see lens flares all over anime. So I'm gonna add a layer over here, and then I'm gonna select a lens flare brush from the brush panel. And I forgot where this brush came from, but you can pretty much download these kinds of brushes for free. And once you got a lens flare brush, you want to pick a lighter shade of orange, and then turn the layer blend mode to screen. And then you can start adding the lens flares. So what I'm doing here is that I'm adding these flares on top of metallic objects and in places where the objects are kind of overexposed by the sunlight. And again, this doesn't have to be perfect or anything, just have fun with it. Okay then, that's just about enough with the lens flares. I think I could add a bit more light. So I'm gonna do that by adding another layer on top, then change the blend mode to screen. And then I'm gonna choose this color and just add some more sunlight, then reduce the opacity, erase some of it from unnecessary areas. And there we have it. And now maybe make the building in the back a bit more anime-like by adding some of this color on top of it using soft light blending mode. And now we are almost done. So one of the final things that I'm gonna add is some sun rays. And for that, I'm gonna add a layer and then turn the blend mode to screen. And then by using a debris brush and this whitish orange color, I'm gonna add some debris. I know it's confusing, but it'll make sense soon. So if you don't have such a brush with you, you can pretty much create this kind of a similar pattern using a rounded brush. And then what you want to do is go to filter, blur, and then choose radial blur. And here you want to increase the amount to 100 and change the blur method to zoom and the quality to good. And then click OK. And then repeat the process once again. And now we got this nice radial rays of light. And all you're gonna do now is arrange these sun rays so that it feels like they're coming from the same direction. And for that, you can increase, rotate, erase, pretty much do anything you want until you're satisfied with the results. And now that we're done, finally, I'm gonna go to filter, then choose stylize. And from this list, I'm gonna choose oil paint. Now, this is a trick that I saw on a tutorial some time ago. Shout out to this channel. And I think this works quite nicely. You can leave the values just like this, or maybe mess around with the values. I mean, this whole step is kinda optional, you don't need to do it, but you know, just try it. And finally, I'm gonna increase the brightness and the contrast using the brightness adjustment layer. And we are done. This is the before and this is the after. And again, the preset is available for download, so if you wanna check that out, the link is in the description. And also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and do all that stuff. And with that being said, I'll see you soon.